Hey, let me ask you something. Have you ever created a campaign on Google and you launch it and you're super pumped? You're like, all my prospective customers are gonna see this. I'm gonna get tons of clicks. I'm gonna outrank all my competitors. And then you go to look for your ads, you search your keywords, and you can never find your own ads. You're not getting any clicks. You're nowhere to be seen. Well, guess what? That's because your ad rank is super low and you're actually losing out to all your competitors. But in this video, I'm really gonna break down what Google ad rank is and how you can improve it, even if you're a complete beginner and you have no idea what it is I'm talking about. And by the way, my name is Silvio Perez and I create content every week on Google Ads and pay-per-click advertising. So if you like that kind of stuff and you get some value from this video, feel free to subscribe to the channel. But without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and hop into my computer and really break down all the variables that go into ad rank and how to improve it so you can take actionable steps moving forward. And by the way, all this stuff I'm gonna talk about moving forward is things from my own personal experience that have helped me and my clients improve their Google ad rank so they can get seen and ultimately get more customers. All right, let's get started. All right, so what is ad rank and how can we go ahead and improve it so we can get our ads seen on the top of the page and beat all our competitors? So first and foremost, ad rank is a score that Google gives you that determines on how likely you are to be on top of the page or below the page depending on these two variables. Ad rank is calculated by your max cost per click bid and your quality score. Your max cost per click bid is the bid levels that you set at the keyword level for your keywords. And then your quality score. Quality score is a metric that Google released that basically just says, how relevant are you to what people are looking for? How well are you solving the searcher's problem? Remember, Google is a business and they want people to continue to use Google. So Google released quality score so that way advertisers can create relevant ads and have relevant landing pages that solve searchers' problems. So when I go to Google and I search for something and I click on that ad, I'm actually gonna find what I'm looking for. So that's what quality score is. Now me personally, when I go to improve ad rank for my clients, I really try to focus more on the quality score side of things and I leave the max cost per click for last. Now that's not to say that max cost per click is not important. It's super important. It's 50% of this equation. But I really try to raise bids as a last resort and I really try to focus on quality score. Now remember, Google Ads is an auction place. As more people compete and bid on these keywords, that's gonna drive max cost per click bids up. So if you're not remaining competitive in your bid price, then you will lose out to your competition and have a much lower ad rank. So let's really go further ahead and diagnose what quality score is made up of so that way you can understand the different elements and improve your quality score to increase your ad rank. So first and foremost, you have ad relevance. Ad relevance is how relevant are your keywords to your ads. Now when it comes to ad relevance, this just basically it comes down to organization in your account. A lot of success with Google Ads just comes down to being well organized. So how well organized are your keywords to your ad groups and to your ads? So by organizing your ad groups thematically, making sure that your keywords are grouped nice and tight, no more than I would say 10, maybe 15 keywords. After that, you're really gonna start losing ad relevance because it's gonna be really hard to match your keywords to your ads. So here's a real example. Let's say I go to Google and I'm looking for dog sitting services. So I search dog sitting services near me. I expect to see an ad that utilizes that keyword dog sitting. So here are the results that I got. And you can see here, here's three different ones. They do reference dog, but something that these advertisers can do to make their ads even more relevant to the keywords that I'm searching is utilize dog sitting instead of pet sitting. So if you see this first ad right here by Rover, in the display URL, they put pet/sitting. Instead of putting that, they should put dog sitting, and that'll be more relevant to the keywords that I'm using. And that'll increase their ad relevance as well. So really this just comes down to organization. How well organized are your ad groups and are you grouping your keywords thematically to your ads? That's ad relevance. Now the next thing is your landing page experience. How relevant are your keywords and ads to your landing page? So going back to that dog sitting example, if I click on one of those ads, I expect to go to a page that talks all about dog sitting services and near my location. So here's an example of a dog landing page from those ads from fitandgopets.com. And the first thing I see is happy dogs, happy world, which is great. So I know at least I'm in the right ballpark that this is something to do with dogs. But even this landing page can be improved in terms of relevance where
I said in my search, I put dog sitting services near me. So perhaps on this landing page, they can have something local to me. So if I'm in Miami, they should have something here that says dog sitting services in Miami, and I can see it right away. Something too, as a something you guys can try out when optimizing your landing pages and designing your landing pages, there's something called the 5-second test that you can run your landing page through. And it's basically very simple. In 5 seconds of me landing on your landing page, I should know what it is you do, who you do it for, and why I should choose you. So kind of run your landing pages through the 5-second test and always make sure that you're tying your landing pages to your ads and to your keywords. Again, going back to that organizational aspect of Google Ads. So if I have an ad group in my campaign that's all about dog sitting, it should have dog sitting keywords, dog sitting ads, and a dog sitting landing page. So everything's relevant so we can promote high ad relevance and high landing page experience, which is gonna improve our quality scores. And by improving our quality scores, our ad rank will go higher and we won't necessarily have to pay more per click to be even more competitive than our advertisers. Now, the next one is our expected click-through rate. And this expected click-through rate, or expected CTR, is just how often does Google perceive your ads will be clicked on versus competitors. Now, from my experience of auditing Google Ads accounts and diagnosing quality score, this is usually the number one deterrent on successful quality scores. Ideally, you want to have quality scores of 7 or greater. It's between 1 and 10, so you usually want to have your quality scores 7 and greater. And expected click-through rate, in my experience, has been the one that hurts people the most, more so than ad relevance and landing page experience. Now, when it comes to your click-through rate, your expected click-through rate being harmed, there's really 4 things that I've noticed in my experience that have really, you know, really are a big deterrent on this. So what harms expected click-through rate, in my experience, is first, your bidding. One could be either your max cost per click bid or your bid strategy. So remember, going back to ad rank, max cost per click bid and quality score are the two variables. But one of the things that I've learned in my experience that is if your max cost per click bid is not set high enough to at least be competitive, your expected click-through rate is going to suffer and your quality score is gonna get dragged down as well. So I've noticed from like smaller accounts I've worked on where they're very, very specific on the max cost per click bids they set, and they're even below the first page level bids that Google gives you as an estimate, that their quality scores are suffering as well, despite the fact that they might have ad relevance and landing page experience average or above average. And the reason for that is since their max cost per click bid is so low, Google's already predicting that since your bid is so low, your ads will not be clicked on very often because you're gonna lose out to other competitors. So just make sure that you put your max cost per click bid to at least be competitive, and then from there you can work on the quality score aspect of things so you can maintain the same bid and still outrank your competitors. And then the second thing is bid strategy. A lot of the times if people try to use things like target CPA bidding and they don't have enough conversion volume, what happens is Google will set your bids so low that your ad rank will get hurt and your expected click-through rate will plummet because, again, your bid level is not competitive enough. So because of your bid strategy, that your expected click-through rate is gonna go down because since your bids are so low, who's gonna click on your ads because they're never gonna get seen. So that's really one of the big ones that I've noticed. Another one is testing. A lot of the times when people have below average expected click-through rates, it's because they do not do frequent ad testing. So this is why ad testing is so important, always trying new concepts in your ads, whether it's dynamic keyword insertion or using your brand name or using more call to actions within the ad copy. But always frequently ad testing is huge because the more frequent you test your ads and you're continuously improving your click-through rates, this is gonna positively impact your expected click-through rate and your quality scores overall. The next thing is extensions. You want to use as many ad extensions as possible. This allows your ads to be larger, take up more page on the search engine result page. And the larger your ad, the more likely your ads will be clicked. And as well as with ad extensions, you're providing the searcher more information. So your ad by default will have a much higher chance of being clicked on than another ad that doesn't utilize all this additional information that they could be attaching to the ad. So just make sure you're using extensions as many as possible. I would say the most important ones are site links, callouts, structured snippets. Those are the big ones. Site links being the number one because they can really take up a lot of space. And then the next one is match types. Your match types can negatively affect your expected click-through rate as well. If your match, your keywords don't have any match types, they're super broad, well, that means you're going to show up for a lot of different searches, whether they're relevant or irrelevant. And by adding in all those irrelevant impressions, your click-through rates are going to go down, versus if you're being more specific, whether it's a phrase match type or an exact match type, where you're going to reduce the amount of impressions, irrelevant impressions that you're receiving, and that way you're showing up more often for the right kind of searches. And by that, by showing up for the right kind of searches more often, your ads will get clicked on more often, and your click-through rates will go up, your expected click-through rates will go up, your quality scores will go up, and your ad rank will increase as well. And then the next one is negative keywords. Aside from just removing irrelevant searches, because at the end of the day, when it comes to advertising, it's really, we want to show our ad to the right person at the right time. That's essentially it. And with negative keywords, of course, we want to remove irrelevant searches. But another aspect that I don't feel like is talked about enough is impressions as well, irrelevant impressions. I don't even want to show up at all for anything irrelevant that I'm advertising on. So if I'm doing dog sitting services, I'm going to block out things like dog sitting books, dog sitting videos, for example. I don't even want my ad to have the potential to show up on those kind of irrelevant searches, regardless if my ads get clicked on. Just the irrelevant impression itself, by getting more impressions and less clicks, your click-through rate is going to go down and your expected click-through rate will be hurt as an effect of that. So I hope that makes sense. So kind of recap, when it comes to your ad rank, it comes down to your max cost per click bid and your quality score. So really, by improving your quality score, you can have a higher ad rank with a less cost per click bid. So for example, my max cost per click bid can be $5 and yours could be 10. But if my quality score is 10 out of 10 and your quality score is 1 out of 10, I can actually outrank you in the search results page by paying less per click. So that's why quality score is super important. But also, do not underestimate the importance of max cost per click as well. Now, moving forward, I want to go ahead and hop into an account and show you how you can modify your columns so you can diagnose your quality score further and see whether or not it's ad relevance that's hurting your quality score, if it's landing page experience, or if it's expected click-through rate. So let's go ahead and do that right now. All right, guys, so I'm here in a live account, and to get started, you're going to go ahead and hop into your Google Ads account, and you're going to click on all campaigns on the top left, and then click on keywords. And then from here, you're going to click on columns, modify columns, and you're gonna go down to quality score. And we wanna make sure we check landing page experience, expected click-through rate, and then add relevance. And then just click apply. And then now you can see here, I'm gonna have to scroll a little bit, but you can see here on the right-hand side, you can see how you're doing landing page experience-wise, how you're doing expected click-through rate-wise, and how you're doing in terms of ad relevance. And then this way you can diagnose which one of those three quality score variables you need to work on the most. And then another thing as well you can do to kind of simplify this, if you have a large account, is you can go ahead and download this as an Excel file, and then you can take this data and you can put it into a pivot table, and then you can segment the pivot table based on one of the three variables, whether you want to see ad relevance, landing page experience, or quality score. A really awesome video you should check out if you want to learn more about pivot tables and quality score is go check out Brad Geddes. That's where I learned about this and how to use pivot tables for quality score, and he has a lot of awesome resources on YouTube you can look at. But that's going to be it for this video. Go ahead and diagnose your quality score, take a look at your max cost per click bids, see where you can improve your ad rank the most, so ultimately you can get your ad seen more often. I hope this video has been helpful. If it has and you got some value from this, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. I create content every week, and I'll see you next time. Take care.